I am a recovered heroin addict, and I had 9%. Are you talking to me? No. I had 9% chance of living, and God pulled me all through that. And now I am a Sunday school teacher, and I'm going to school, and I'm living for the Lord. And I started going to school now, and I'm taking psychology. And today I talked to my psychology teacher, and you can tell he's a skeptic and everything. But I told today we were talking about drugs, and I told him today a little bit about my story. And like he wanted to listen, and you could see like that glimmer of hope. Like I can tell him my story, but he wanted to listen. And he wanted to listen, like how God, like, he wanted to listen to that. And I feel like that's a window and how I can get in and. Like it's pretty cool, and that's God's grace, and I mean that could be the window of God's salvation for him. You never know. Yeah. God done a lot for me.
Stand with us and sing page 278 in the blue book, While the Ages Roll. Let's fellowship together. We'll gather around and pray after we sing this. Thank you.
And while the ages roll, I'll keep on praising Him, and my voice will never tire nor grow, and my song shall ever be, praise the Lamb who died for me, and I'll sing.
Ever be, praise the Lamb who died for me. I'll sing it while the ages shall roll. It's good to be in the Lord's house tonight and feel His presence. Appreciate so much our visitors being with us tonight. Thank you for coming. There's been some that's traveled quite a distance. We're honored to have you here. We just ask that you just be obedient. Mind the Lord tonight. Let's worship Him. We're going to gather around and pray. Ask everybody that will, let's make our way up to the altar tonight. Let's call upon the Lord. Ask Him to touch the service and have His way tonight.
Thank you. it's been a long, long road, and my soul has grown so weary, I just can't understand all the struggles within me. There's been times I've strayed away, and even times I could not pray, but somehow my faith would say, just hold on, there's a brighter day. He never gave up, he never gave up. Mercy reached down, and that was enough. If you could see who I was before, then I'm sure that you'll
service with the Lord. I need to welcome him in, and because somebody's soul might be in the balance tonight. So just pray for me as we sing one more.
What a sad time in heaven, the angels gathered round the throne. They couldn't stand to watch Jesus dying all alone. it broke their hearts to see the blood that he shed. They were all prepared to fly, but God turned to them and said, "Angel, sit down. He's not gonna call. He's saving the world, becoming sin for them all. I know that you can save him, but he's not the one in need. So angel, sit down. Let him set the captives free. Children go marching in to our home beyond the skies. As we meet our blessed Savior, all the angels will form a band. They'll start to sing a song, but God turns to them and says, "Angels, sit down. Children
away as wounds which more than bunch of redeemed Christians. Not worth a whole lot, and that one ain't worth saving, and that one over there probably ain't worth saving neither. But the Lord said there's grace for them all. Amen. Grace for them all. Amen. January 26, 1992, I found out that there was all the grace in God's world for me. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. This world wouldn't give you a blood nickel for Ken Beasley. But I found that the Lord gave his one and only son just for me.
Last time that you saw me, I
Trials and temptations that we go through day by day. Just remember all he's done, how he was with you all the way. And his grace will be sufficient. No matter where you are, what you're going through. Trials and temptations that we go through day by day. Just remember all he's done, how he was with you all the way. And his grace will be sufficient, no matter where you are or what you're going through. Sufficient. It will always be sufficient for every trial that comes to you.
sometimes I feel the weight of every trial. So I count the cost and trust you as your child. I saw your crown of thorns, how you gladly wore it. Every cross I bear, I'm stronger for it. Lord, when the way gets hard and you show me how to follow your footsteps and cast away my doubt, I saw your temptation, how you stood before it. Yeah, I'm tempted too, but I'm stronger for it. Make me stronger for
exceedingly greatly grand. belongs to the Lord. Moses, the one that stretched and brought out the Red Sea part and went over dry. Moses, the one that struck the river and it turned to blood. Moses, the man of God. Moses, the... but he wasn't that man yet. Wasn't that man yet, my friend? He went crying to the Lord. He said, Lord, since you've sent me down here, there's been more evil brought upon the people. Lord, why'd you send me down here? Then in chapter 6, the Lord answers him. And he tells him eight things. Now, beginning in verse 6. Yeah, basically 6. Chapter 6, verse 6.
All right, this is Miss Callie. She's been coming for some time, been in Bible school, so on and so forth, and we've had the opportunity to minister to her and to love her, and but tonight something special's happened, and I'll let her tell you what's took place.
The Lord saved me.
Been good to us. Oh my. Well, the Lord wanted to save a little girl. What about that? Oh my. Wanted to save a little girl. about the night God saved you. Hallelujah. I want us to gather around. I want us to have prayer. Let's pray for sinners. Let's pray for our generation. Let's pray for the power of God. As a birthing room, a little birthing room got set up over here. Being born is a serious matter. Being born not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, that which is born of the spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said to thee, you must be born again. You ain't never seen a baby born quick. It's birthing room. This watered down easy believism ain't gonna fly, it ain't gonna float. Getting born again. Somebody else might need to be saved. Let's come around and pray for a little while and pray for our generation to have the power of God. We'll see what the Lord's got for us.
If I could count the tears that have fallen, it would seem like an ocean to me. And if my heart were a window you could look through, oh, the pain and scars you
are well. To the right hand of my Father. And preacher. It's good preaching. Good preaching. Bless him, Lord.
It's probably too late now. Oh, but I don't let that worry me much. I'm happy anyhow. As I go along life's journey, I'm reaping better than I've sown. I'm drinking from my saucer. from my socks.
Are things taking place in that home in the sky? Excitement is mounting as time draws nigh. The pearly gates glisten, the golden streets gleam. They're getting ready in glory to crown. Trumpet has sounded and time is no more. When the last weary pilgrim has walked through the door. When the heavenly choir has gathered to sing, they'll be ready. Lift your weary eyes homeward and tarry no more. Look beyond human bondage to that bright golden shore. Though the night finds us weary, come morning we'll sing. They're just about ready to crown. Trumpet has sounded and time is no more. When the last weary pilgrim has walked through the door, when the heavenly choir has gathered to sing, they'll be ready in glory to crown.
Counts the stars one and all. He knows how much sand is on the shore. He sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the sea. He's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. And he knows my name. Don't don't know what tomorrow will bring. I can't tell you what's in store. I don't know a lot of things. I don't have all the answers to the questions of life. Knowing whom I have and he knows my name. Every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry, he knows my name. When I'm overwhelmed by the pain, I can't see the light of day. Picked up her basket and headed for home. She had come with them empty, but now they were full. She walked through the door to Naomi's delight. Naomi said, daughter, explain it to me. Whose field did you glean in so bountifully? Ruth told her Boaz was a man's name, and this is why. Like little Ruth, I too can say that I have a Redeemer who blesses each day with more than I need, and he's always on time. So Ruth's testimony care, and everywhere looked, there was a blessing, a handful right here and a handful right there. And I must confess, I'm so undeserving, but it sure feels good to
I just want to say it's been such a blessing tonight to see little Grace coming, except the Lord, I get to pick her up on that school bus every morning, and we listen to gospel music every morning. I told her and Charity this evening, I said, no, you get in there and cook my supper, I'll be right back. Boy, I fed tonight, and I'm thankful for that.
She picked up her basket and headed for home. She had come with them empty, but now they were full. She walked through the door to Naomi's delight. Ruth had a story that would change both her life. Naomi said, daughter, explain it to me. Whose field did you glean in so bountifully? Ruth told her, Boaz was the man's name, and this is that I have a Redeemer who blesses each day with more than I need, and He's always on time. So Ruth's testimony is a whole lot like mine, and
wonder how many times throughout that Bible when Jesus was walking down the street that is a little awkward.
Sure.
Amen.
Sure.
And then He showed out. Amen. I'm glad tonight. I'm glad tonight that he's seen fit to pass by our way. And boy, we still got a lot of work to do. Church, family, neighbors, visitors here. We've got a lot of work to do. There's no time for us to get sidetracked. There's no time for us to sit down. And there's no time for us to be discouraged. Hey, well, I believe this is all in my heart. And Brother Dean, you've done a fantastic job preaching the other night, that prophecy tie and all that. This thing's winding up. Amen. For the Christian people, now ain't the time to be discouraged and sad and quiet. Now's the time to be excited. Amen. Our final victory just lies just around it. We've already won this thing through Jesus Christ. Amen. But some of these days, we're going to get to be in his presence. Amen. That's the final victory. Amen. And it's just right around the corner. Amen. So I say to you tonight, don't be discouraged, but be encouraged. Amen. Hey, I'd love, in my vision for Calvary Baptist Church tonight, to see it plumb full. Plumb full, and the Holy Spirit passing by, folks getting saved. But hey, man, listen, if it's less than that, it's still yet. I want to see the Holy Spirit pass by. And if it's less than half, I still want to see the Holy Spirit pass by. And if there's two of us, I want to see the Holy Spirit pass by. I want him to be honored and glorified in everything said and done. And I thank the Lord that for this week, and we've still got some time to go. Shady Grove's going to be here tomorrow night. I don't know, Brother Dean, you're going to be able to come back, or maybe, or no, or... All right, that'd be just fine. Brother Dean's fixing to fly out to Albania. I don't even know where that's at, Brother Dean. I need to look at that on the map and see how you're going to go about getting there. But you pray for him. We already have been praying for him. And Albania, going to be going. And, boy, I was thinking about it. Going to be walking down the street right in Rome, right where the Apostle Paul walked. Right before they beheaded him, is that correct? He said so. Boy, I'm glad he wasn't discouraged, ain't you?
Yeah, where would we be?
Amen. You know what some of my favorite scripture is over there where he was encouraging Timothy? Right. I believe this with all my heart, and I don't know. You can take it or leave it tonight, and I'll get out of the way, and we'll praise the Lord and go home. But I say this. I believe that the whole time he was writing and encouraging the church, encouraging Timothy, he could hear the axe sharpening in the background. Wonder what he was singing when he was headed down that road, Brother Dave. I thought about that last night. Wonder what he was thinking. I believe this with all my heart. I don't believe he's discouraged. I believe his head was held high. I believe he's saying this. There's victory in Jesus. Amen. Amen. I believe this tonight, there's victory in Jesus. I thank God for the soul saved, and Miss Callie over there, and smiles. I call her smile. She's got the prettiest smile. I tell her that all the time, and I told her tonight. I said, "Boy, they ain't no prettier smile than right now." When I walked over there to hug her up after she just accepted Christ as her Savior, isn't that wonderful? Amen. Hey, Mom and Dad, I appreciate you coming in tonight and right on time. Thank God for that. Anybody got anything? I don't want to short nobody out of a blessing tonight.
I just want to thank God for the service. And thank you for always giving me what you need. And I'm always thankful for the
Good. All right, so Brother Dean, first night he's here, he said he didn't need a dime, so we're not going to pick up special love off him for him tonight. No. Did I hear that right? I believe I heard that. But they said, I don't need a dime tonight. Amen. I tell you what we are going to do, though. I'm going to ask the ushers to come up. We are going to take up a special love offering for him tonight, and we're going to see that he's taken care of and his needs are met this week. And praise the Lord, Brother Dean. You've been a blessing to me. In them hard times, in them dark times where it's just me and the Lord, you've been a blessing to me, and I thank God for you. All right, Brother Jake, if you'd pray and ask the blessing over the offering. Yes, God. Yes, Father. Yes, thank you so much. Amen. People to come on up here. Woo-wee. Amen. Praise the Lord, Miss Gracie. Don't knock the pulpit over, please. Appreciate it. All right.